and she's over here sleeping in her hammock. I just saw that she moved. She is awake. I've been a little bit worried if she's been cold tonight.
Oh yeah.
Oh, you have?
Traveling north to Norway was lovely, but also quite a lonely experience. I didn't meet any travelers, and social distancing was a big thing at this point. I was wild camping most of the time and didn't really mind the solitude. But things were about to change when I ran into this lady. On a petrol station on the E6 highway, I spotted a BMW with a monkey on the back and found a young girl in a leather suit eating an ice cream. We immediately clicked and decided to take off together.
So where are we now?
I don't know. In the middle of Norway.
I don't know either. We found us this little place at some boathouses at this lake and beautiful mountains there in the back. It's really late. I think it's like 8:30 in the evening.
9 o'clock.
And I met this amazing lady. We're gonna set up a camp here tonight and we can make a fire. Oh, I'm so happy. So I'm gonna set up camp right here. I had a long, long, long day today. Been riding since 9:30 this morning and then until now. It's 9 o'clock and managed to really do some miles today for the first time. That means that hopefully tomorrow evening I'm gonna make it all the way to Bodø, where I can take the ferry to Lofoten. But now it's setting up camp time.
Morning.
I want to show you this amazing view. Oh, look at this here. So yesterday at a petrol station I met Ann-Katrin, and she is riding for 1 year now. She's 20 years old and she's over here sleeping in her hammock. I just saw that she moved. She is awake. I've been a little bit worried if she's been cold tonight.
Oh yeah.
Oh, you have? Are you okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh. We're gonna cook some breakfast now and maybe make a fire again to make sure that Ann-Katrin gets warm. Takes the shape of Norway.
Oh my god, that's scheiße. Oh.
We are now here at the Arctic Circle.
A lot of mosquitoes here.
It's crazy. There's so many mosquitoes. It's like we are under full attack. What is it now? 9 o'clock in the evening? It's so light up here. Oh, we are gonna drive a few hours more because there's nothing stopping us. We had quite a slow morning, right?
Oh yeah.
Cooking pancakes like forever and just hanging out and having fun.
Started at 2 o'clock.
Yeah,
right.
But we now made it to the Arctic Circle and that feels really good. Oh my god, I have a mosquito in my helmet. Help me. Ah! Damn it! Okay, mosquitoes, behind this zone here, this is like no-go zone, okay? Stay out. And Katrine and I, we are here somewhere just outside Bodø.
Somewhere in the nowhere.
Somewhere in the forest. We've been driving all day. Suddenly it was really late for us and we just couldn't find a place to camp. So we've been driving around and we met all these dead ends. So now I'm not sure we're supposed to be here. There was a fence, but we managed to get around it. And now we are setting up our tents and plan to get out of here really early tomorrow before we get in trouble. So we have an interview tomorrow morning with the BMW club for Norway. I'm not sure that we should tell them how we are camping. I'm not sure they will support our decisions here. But anyways, we hope that we're like too far into the forest that any caretaker is gonna come by and fine us some humongous Norwegian fine. I better set up my tent and get some sleep. I'm too tired actually for... Oh! No, it was my arm. So, okay, it turned out I'm in the forest with a fucking lunatic who's trying to kill me. Yeah, I think we're over the top tired.
Are you tired? Oh my god, I'm so under adrenaline. But I need a lot of eat.
But the thing is, we haven't eaten much. We had a few pancakes this morning, and then we had this bun. It was a big bun, this cinnamon.
Oh, yeah,
but yeah. And then we had a hot chocolate. That's it. And we've been going on all day. So I think...
I had 3 hot chocolates.
Yeah, we had quite a lot of hot chocolates because it was so damn cold on the highway. But yeah, it just went on and on. I mean, Norway is just pretty brutal. Kills your butt. So neither of us have heated handles, which is definitely a mistake, but we survived. And you know, I have this awesome climb suit, but Anne-Katrine, she's just going in this leather suit, and I don't know how she keeps warm. I think she's like pretty warm-blooded.
No, I'm freezing all the time. But leather suit, it looks cool. I like it.
Yeah, she looks very good in it. So we better get some sleep. It's 2 o'clock and we have to get up at 8. And at 10 we are giving this interview. So the camera just ran out of battery as this lady walked by here. I was a little bit afraid that we were going to get into trouble, but she just smiled at me and waved, and I was like... So I'm pretty impressed because Catherine pretty much wild camps every night, which for me is a little bit too uncomfortable. And I guess that's really why you're able to travel this far with little funds, is because you really don't spend a lot of money.
Yeah.
And of course you're sponsored, but the BMW doesn't pay for your food, you know, it doesn't pay for your campgrounds. So she still has to finance that.
Yeah.
By selling a picture once in a while, and
but it's crazy because everybody thinks that I have a lot of money because of the BMW, and for me it's one of the best things I ever had, that I can drive a BMW. I mean, I would never have money for this, but that does not mean that I have money. I'm not rich.
But you know, she has a few very cool things. She has the most awesome tent. And she has camera. I mean, yeah, this is actually, when you hold that camera that way, that is so cool. And I think she's a very skilled photographer. Most importantly, she's so much fun to hang out with, and that's what matters in the end. We're gonna go downtown to Bodø now, and then we're gonna find some tickets and go to Lofoten to check that place out.
Das ist gut.
Das ist
perfekt.
Warte, ich mach mal Motor wieder an.
Ja, warte. Perfekt. Wir haben schon einen ganz schön viel Blicken bekommen.
Ja.
So, here we are at the harbor area in Bodø. We're waiting for the ferry. It's gonna leave at 3 o'clock. And so we're gonna go to Lofoten. Which is awesome that she's coming with me. I really had to persuade her. So ferry ride is gonna be, what was it, 4.5 hour? And then we're gonna spend some time on Lofoten and just enjoy the scenery, do some wild camping, go swimming again, and maybe wash a little bit because we stink.
No, we don't.
I think.
You can't smell it.
My feet are stinking.
Hello?
Hi.
You have a security device.
Okay. Oh my god. I think he fell in love with you.
Oh.
He was really like...
Oh my god. We just arrived in Lofoten. It was so stressful when we had to get the bike out of the ferry because we weren't allowed down on the deck where the bikes were. So once they opened the doors, we had to like super, super quickly get everything out. And they were like, oh, you have to hurry up. So we were a little bit stressful. And then Anne-Katrine went out, was fine. And I was there in between some trucks. And then I lost the balance. And I'm so upset because I dropped the bike and no one saw it. I was all alone. Well, I think the truck driver, he saw it. And then this guy working on the ferry, he was kind of looking at me like, okay, another biker dropped her bike. So he came over and did the exercise of the day and helped me lift up the bike. Now we're here getting our shit organized in the harbor of Lofoten. It is pretty goddamn amazing here. The mountains are right there. And Katrine is getting organized.
Oh, I have too many stuff with me.
Maybe a little bit much. We have found this place to camp. The road is pretty near, but there's definitely nothing wrong with the views. Pretty
amazing.
Huh? So we thought we were gonna put our tent up there and then we can just push the bikes in there a little bit. Then it's pretty private. And then we will have this beautiful view here tomorrow morning. Set up the tent in this nice soft moss. And up here, Anne-Katrine setting up her tent. And down there are the bikes. Our tents are now up and pretty much ready for bed. I think it's only 8 o'clock now. So we'll go and see what Anne-Katrine is up to.